Thank you very much. As you can tell by the program, jazz music can sometimes have some weird names. I mean, Hayburner, the chicken. Who knows what that's going to be. But I like Hayburner. It's a nice, simple, easy, swingy tune. It's in the mood for some jazz. The next one we do is a ballad, Hospital Blues. And then we'll be followed up with the chicken. I wish I could come up with a storyline for that, but I guess it's as good as mine.
Thank you.
Being here, I should also mention that the Hospital Blues feature David Jenkins on the trumpet as soloist.
Yeah! I love you, David!
And Benson here on the piano. As well. This next one's going to feature Lynx on the tenor sax. Anyone else? Julie? Okay, good. Oh, I should also mention that I think this is what going to be. We've had what, four rehearsals before this performance. So we started jazz band after marching season, which, as most of you know, ends in the middle of November. So since the middle of November to until now, taking a week off for Thanksgiving, I think it came a long way. Just for less than five rehearsals together. So. And now let's find out what a chicken sounds like. Thank you. All right, we will now take a brief intermission to strike the stage, set it up for our concert section. So I'll be back with you in hopefully no more than 10 minutes. Thank you. And even though it has two main themes throughout, it has the SARS theme, which is the theme that's played in the beginning, and it goes into this lovely legato section that's the bride, and then it introduces a third theme in the end to symbolize the unity of SARS bride. Thank you. Great. This next piece is called Rest by Frank Kelly. This is actually a rewrite of one of his pieces called There Will Be Rest for Choir that he wrote about 10 years before this one. And this one where he lost in words, he was able to make up in some very minute details in the music. So I think you'll enjoy this one.
Thank you.
Now there's going to be a very quick set change. We're going to have Symphonic Band move out into these seats, and magically these seats will be empty, and Concert Band will be setting up on stage. The next couple pieces we're going to play, this next one is called Great Locomotive Chase. I chose it exclusively based on the name, because who could resist? Actually, I saw the name and I thought, that would make a really good field show for next year. But we ended up not going that route. Don't think the team picked. But this is still a cool piece, so we're going to keep playing. There's a whole story behind this piece if you're interested in a search history of the railroad. There you go. It's just a commissioned piece based on railroad. He wants something chugging along. At certain points, you hear fun things like steam being released from the engine. You hear the engine revving up and the snare drum. You hear the Doppler effect of the train rushing by. And there's some cool stuff in this piece.
Thank you.
transition between pieces, you might notice that some students are getting up and walking around. It's not because they're bored. It's because we try our best to rotate parts so that everyone gets to play the first part in the concert, everyone gets to play the third part in the concert, everyone gets to play solo trumpet two, or whatever it is. We want everyone to try and have the same opportunities as possible without making people audition for seats because that's stressful for everyone. This next tune is called the Irish Tune from County Derry. A lot of you may know it as O Danny Boy. This is a traditional Irish tune, one of Percy Grainger's most famous pieces, band standard. If you go to high school anywhere, you'd be like, oh, Irish tunes are on that. It's a great teaching opportunity. It's a slow song. It teaches them that slow music can be very difficult. I'm sure they've learned that. Hopefully. I hope. All right.
Thank you.
And now we'll have another transition into both combined bands of both Symphonic Band and Concert Band. As they're getting set up, as we'll just talk about the space for a little bit. This is second suite in F. This is Gustav Soll's second suite for band. His first one was in E-flat. It's another band standard. Second suite in F, it leads itself very much to England. It starts off with a march, both English, and then it goes to Scottish march, which is in one and a two, the English side, and one, two, pull that, the Scottish side. Then goes on to a love ballad of a woman singing her loss of her lover who was shipped away to the military by his parents to avoid their relationship. Song of the Blacksmith talks about the blacksmith and his rugged characteristic. You hear it, we have an anvil also that gets struck. It's pretty fun. And then the theme of the Dark Sun, you will be very familiar with it, and I guarantee you'll say, where is that from? Where is that from? And we sprinkle on another melody on top of that and see if you can identify it afterwards.
Thank you.
Now as we transition to our last piece, you'll notice a lot of people changing instruments, getting up, moving around, doing so very quietly. While they are setting up for our final piece, which is a goodbye to our fantastic field show that we performed and perfected this year, taking us from... taking us from the beginning of band camp all the way until we are near second place finish at Vintage High School out of 9 bands around the Vision. Very successful marching year, and we owe it partially to our music chess, which we will send off very greatly. Our very own drum major, Jermon Jacquard, will be conducting as his final before we get started, though, we're going to have a message from the Danish president, Natalie Hans.
Good evening, and I'm not going to take too much time because I am not the main event. These people are. My name is Natalie Amundsen. I'm the president of the Terra band Boosters. We're a group of parents and alumni, John Beckner, and some other great people who show up and help get things done physically and financially so that these students can do what they do best. So I'm here to tell you that we are here doing this. We are going to pass around some buckets if you want to help support the band and their efforts. Above and beyond that, I want to tell Mr. Brian Musetter how happy we are to have him here. It's his first year. And I, for one, think he's done a fantastic job. I'm so pleased, and I'm totally blown away by what I'm hearing today. So, not getting choked up, just not good at public speaking. I'm going to take 1 minute and say this to you students. Wow, and I'm so proud, and you should be proud of yourselves. You do something that not everyone can, and it's amazing. What making music takes you to a part of your brain that nothing else does and ever can. And it helps us find that same place of joy. So thank you and have a great last number.